Islamia. I'm sorry and apologize that we are running late, and so we will start immediately. May I request Janab Shahid Mehdi Sahab to please come on the stage. Mr. Dr. Shahid Mehdi Sahab, Dr. Shahid Jamil Sahab, Janab Masroor Khan Sahab, Professor Ilyas Hussain, to please come on the dais, on the stage. Please come. Majid Jamil Sahab, you are requested to please come with the guests. Chancellor Jamia Millia Islamia, in whose vibrant tenure we saw establishment of several important departments and centers. He has served as an administrator, a diplomat, and in his person continues to be a goodwill ambassador of India on many fronts. So we welcome you, and I must go on record here today to gratefully acknowledge the continuous support and encouragement that Jamia has been receiving from him. We thank you, sir, from the core of our heart. We are honored to have with us today Janab Masroor Khan Sahab, great-grandson of Hakim Ajmal Khan Sahab, the founder of Jamia. Masroor Khan Sahab is carrying forward the legacy of his illustrious ancestors and resides with his family in the legendary Haveli, the Sharif Manzil, that was once the hub of freedom struggle activities. It also housed the Hindustani Dawakhana that treated the poor masses of India free of cost, and for which Hakim Ajmal Khan came to be lovingly called the Masihul Mulk. Masroor Sahab, aapki maujoodgi hamare liye fakhr aur hausle ka baais hai. Bahut shukriya khane ke liye. In the audience, we also have Ms. Kulan Amin, granddaughter of Professor Muhammad Ajib. I welcome you, Ms. Kulan, and hope that you will associate yourself with Jamia, just reminding us of Professor Muhammad Mujib. I extend a very warm welcome to the speakers, Dr. Muhammad Rashid Ahmad, Dr. Ahmed Saeed, Professor Farhat Nasreen, Professor Muhammad Hashim Qureshi, Professor Muhammad Amin Ullah, Professor Deepak Kumar, and Dr. Meher Hussain. I welcome each of you, all the delegates, esteemed guests, the press, the learned faculty members, and all my dear students.
I'm privileged to announce here the presence of the very elegant daughter-in-law of Abdul Majid Khwaja Sahab. She's right here in the audience with us. And two of his granddaughters are here. Mala Nigar and Rashmi Noreen are here. The son-in-law, a grandson-in-law is also present here, Faizi. I welcome them all to our institute.
Indeed, I welcome them all. Their presence here has added a beautiful dimension to this session. Many of you may know how Jamia came to be established, but for the sake of some of our new students here and guests who may not be so familiar, let me give you a brief background of how, so that you may enjoy the papers today. With the unmerited development of the year 1919, like the Rowlatt Act, followed by the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy, Mahatma Gandhi gave a call for non-cooperation with the British government. education was an important agenda on the of the non-cooperation movement. Gandhiji and other nationalist leaders of the time were very uncomfortable with the British government's agenda to train the youth of India as obedient servants of the crown. So Gandhiji appealed to all education institutions to stop receiving funds, awards, honors to discourage British dictates and interference in the education system. In the Muslim Anglo-Oriental College of Aligarh, a group of students responded to the call of the Mahatma and went along with the Khilafat leaders like Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar, Hakim Ajmal Khan, Dr. Mukhtar Ahmad Ansari, Khwaja Abdul Majid, who were leading the non-cooperation movement at that time. These nationalists took upon themselves to set up an independent national institution that is today the Jamia Millia Islamia. It was inaugurated by the veteran freedom fighter Maulana Mahmudul Hasan of the Silk Letter Movement fame in Aligarh on 29th of October 1920. Jamia started in tents, and its long journey through the arduous terrain to finally becoming this beautiful central university that we are in today would not have been possible without the sacrifices and the daring stand of our founding fathers for a national university that spelled the end of dictates and dependency. Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar would recite, Mumkin hai nalai jab se, ruk bhi sake agar, hum par to hai wafa ka taqaza, jafa ke baad. We on Jamia's centenary year celebrate, cherish and salute the founding fathers of Jamia Millia Islamia. I now, with the permission of the chair, call upon Dr. Abdul Rashid Agwan to speak on Muhammad Ali Johar, the illustrious founder and the first vice chancellor of Jamia Millia Islamia, someone who died fighting for India's freedom. Our speaker, Dr. Agwan, may I request him to come on the dial, on the stage. Our speaker, Dr. Agwan, please, is a social activist. He's a political analyst, Islamic scholar, and author of many books. He's currently the president of the Institute for Policy Studies and Advocacy, an NGO engaged in analysis of government policies and budgets from the point of view of weaker section. I request Dr. Abdul Rashid Agwan. Meanwhile, I request our next speaker to please come on the stage and take the seat here. Dr. Ahmed Said Sahab, will you please come on the stage and take the seat of the speaker? Please.
Thank you very much. Mr. Chairman, distinguished guests and faculty, and learned audience, please let me begin my presentation, Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar, a leader par excellence, with his own couplet, which reads, Dore hayat aayega qatil teri qaza ke baad, Dore hayat aayega qatil teri qaza ke baad, hai ittida hamari teri intaha ke baad.
Fatima is at the Sarojini Naidu Center for Women's Studies in Jamia, and she has done two beautiful monographs on Professor Muhammad Mujib, one published from Sahitya Academy and the other from Nehru Memorial Museum Library. And we really compliment you on your work on Professor Muhammad Mujib. Thank you. Thank you so much. With these founding fathers, we, Jamia, was also fortunate to have some very fine faculty members who dedicated their life in the service of Jamia and pledged to receive not more than ₹100, sometimes not even that, but continued serving Jamia as its life members. We would fall in our duty if we don't acknowledge their contribution today. So this hall must echo their name, and allow me to briefly tell you who these wonderful life members and teachers of Jamia were. Hafiz Fayaz Ahmed Sahab, Janab Shafiqur Rahman Qidwai, who started the Idara Taleem and who later went on to become the Education Minister of Delhi. Maulana Muhammad Aslam Jairajpuri. I hope our colleague is here, Aman Jairajpuri Sahab. No, he is not here, but he is also here with us. Janab Irshadul Haq, Janab Saad Ansari, Janab Hamid Ali Khan Sahab, who took hold of the Maktaba Jamia and ran it in an admiring fashion, that Gandhiji said, let all the books be published from Maktaba Jamia under him. Janab Saeed Ansari Sahab, Janab Khwaja Abdul Hai Sahab, Dr. Abid Hussain, a friend of Dr. Zakir Hussain, who had studied in Germany and who came with Professor Mujib and Dr. Hussain and Dr. Zakir Hussain and served Jamia. Professor A.J. Kinlan, Miss Gerda Phillips-Born, who came all the way from Germany to serve Jamia. She lived and died here and is buried here. Janab Muhammad Aqeel, Janab Ali Ahmed, Abdul Ghaffar Madori, who wrote that beautiful Jamia Ki Kahani, which is a source of inspiration to all of us. Janab Akhtar Hussain Farooqi Sahab, Abdul Hai Sahab, Janab Sir Ahmed Ali Azad Sahab, Muhammad Hussain Sahab, Abdul Razak Sahab, Sayyid Mujtaba Hussain Zaidi Sahab, Muhammad Shafi Uddin Nayyar Sahab, Janab Hafiz Nabi Ahmed Sahab, Janab Barkat Ali Firak Sahab, whose son Professor Ali is here, and we are really honored that you are here, sir, with us today. Kya log the wo jo rahe wafa se guzar gaye, ji chahta hai naqshe kadam chumti chalo. I now invite Professor Majid Jamil Sahab to offer a vote of thanks and to give the mementos to the speakers and the honorable guest. Thank you, Professor Majid Sahab.